Hello everyone, welcome to part 9 of advanced ecom series in Laravel 6. And in this video we are going to start working on the settings page where we are going to work on change password. Okay, so let's log in into the admin panel. We have admin at the rate of admin.com and password is 123456. Okay, so I'm going to sign in. So we have done this dashboard page a few videos earlier, and we have also done Laravel validations in last video that we are going to use again and again in every form in our Laravel website. And now here we are going to create one link settings page link, okay? And we will also do that welcome kind of thing, like welcome admin. See here, this is our admins table that we have created a few videos back. And you can see the type here. Right now we have given the type as admin, and we have also given subadmin. Okay, so our database, I'm going to check this. This is our database. Okay, that is our database. Okay, so see, this admin and subadmin kind of thing we will do in future videos. We are going to add the types so that admin can add subadmin, and we will give some privileges, means like features we are going to do later on. Here in left sidebar we are going to do some features like products, like managing products, categories, discount, vouchers, orders, and admin can give those privileges to subadmin, that what features subadmin can assess. All those things we are going to do in later videos, but right now we will work on change password so that main admin can change its password as well. Okay, I want to see its database, that which database we are using. Sorry, not this one. Here it is, we are using ecom6. Okay, so this is the table that we are using, ecom6 table. Okay, so you can see here that we will try to log in with admin at the rate of admin.com. this we are using right now. Okay, we are logging with this one, and this is the hash password, and that is 123456. So we are going to change this password in setting page. Okay, so that thing we are going to do now. Okay, so first of all I am going to create settings page itself. And one more thing I want to tell you, that now we are using guards for maintaining all these admins. We are using guards, and for getting the details we need to use guard as well. Okay, so I want to show you that how we can get the details from the guard and how we are using here. Now see, we have logged in. Now we have a guard here, means we are using here guard. We can fetch details from the that auth guard, admin auth guard. We can get details, admin details from that guard. Okay, so that thing also. So let's start working on this thing. First of all, I am going to create the route for settings page. Okay, in web.php file I am going to create the route, and here the earlier route we have created the dashboard route. Now we are going to create the route as settings route we are going to create. Okay, so I'm going to create the same route here, settings route. I'm going to create settings. Okay, and one thing I want to tell you here, that this route also we are going to put in admin middleware group, so that no unauthorized access can able to access this route. Okay, so now see here, no need to mention admin in front of this one, because admin is prefix. Admin we have already prefix, and we have given the namespace as admin as well. And this is a kind of group for admin. You can see that we have namespace as admin, means we are adding everything in admin there. We can go and check it out. HTTP controllers, and you can see we have admin folder, and we are putting all the controllers in admin folder here. And in resources as well, we have the admin folder here as well, resources, views, and admin folder here, separate folder. We are putting everything here. All the blade files are here in admin folder. Okay, so we are using everything, and main thing here that we are putting every all the admin controller, like admin controller in here in admin folder itself. Okay, here you can see app http controllers, and so you can see there is no admin controller. Admin controller is admin folder. Okay, and other folders in later videos when we will work on products categories and other things, that controller we are going to create separate folder and we are going to put in admin folder itself. And this is the admin folder, and so we have given here namespace, because namespace is admin, because we have put everything in admin folder. You can watch that Laravel 6 basic series that I have launched some time back, that will make the things more clear. Okay, here you can see in I have provided you link also, you can watch that one, so that all these basics will clear to you. Okay, so sorry for that. Okay, so we can we have added here settings, and here also I'm going to add the settings functions. Okay, we are going to add the settings function in admin controller, same like dashboard. So I'm going to open admin controller, and here same like dashboard, I'm going to create setting function. Here I'm going to return this one. I am going to create admin underscore settings blade file. That also I'm going to create, I have shown you that resources, views, folder, and I'm going to create that there only resources, views, admin. Okay, so here I am going to create that admin here, sorry, admin underscore settings blade file. Okay, so I can do one thing, I can simply open admin underscore dashboard and save it. Okay, and I'm going to save it like file, save as admin underscore settings. Okay, it's very simple enough. Okay, I can do it like this, admin underscore settings. Okay, so we can do it like this. Admin underscore settings dot blade.php file is now created. We have just saved that admin underscore dashboard as admin underscore settings, because everything will remain the same. Only the middle content will change. Okay, so we are going to change the middle content here in this file. And one thing I want to show you, that in previous basic series, we have already done this one. You can open in the website that we have created in our basic series, this website, Stack Developers. And here also you can check out that we have done the settings page, you can see. And same kind of form we are going to create here in advanced ecom series as well, because there is nothing to change. Okay, here also we have used Ajax. You can see that we have used the Ajax. If you type the password, it will tell that current password is correct or not. Okay, so same kind of functionality we are going to follow. Okay, but the only difference is here we are using that auth. Okay, we are not use multi auth here. And later on, in later videos, we are started using session for admin, but now we are using guards, we are using multi auth, we are using multiple auth, one for user and one for admin. Okay, so this is the difference. Okay, so also we are using Laravel 6 instead of Laravel 5.6 or 5.7. so yeah, one more thing, that we are going to upgrade this project to Laravel 7 very soon. And if you have started working on Laravel 7, see, Laravel 7 has just been launched. Okay, so you can also see how to install Laravel 7. We have video for that also, how to install Laravel 7. And this series can also follow on Laravel 7, so you can install Laravel 7 and can start this series from the scratch. There is no issue at all. Okay, or you can able to upgrade this series, this Laravel 6 series to Laravel 7. That also I'm going to show video might be next one or next to next one. I'm going to update this project to Laravel 7. Okay, so now see, I am telling you that these settings will help us, like same kind of thing we want here, settings page, and here admin settings. So we can write it down here. We can add settings, home admin settings. Okay, so admin settings we have done, and that is fine. Okay, so see, this middle content, we need to update this middle content. This middle content, I am going to remove this middle content. This one is not required here, but I want to add some other content that I will copy. But first of all, I will remove this one. Here you can see, sorry, here I can simply open settings. There's some issue. Now we are going to check. Okay, this one, semicolon is not. Okay, so our settings page is ready, but we want here form. So we will check our AdminLTE template, and there we have complete details. Complete template is there, AdminLTE template. You just need to go inside this template and you can open this admin index.html. Okay, here you can go in forms. Okay, they provided general elements, and this is the form that we want to take. Okay, this is the form that we want to take for all the forms in admin. We will take this one for change password right now, and for other form, for other functionality as well, we can take this form as well. Okay, so I will take this form, and this is the page in pages, forms, and general.html. I'm going to copy this page, pages, forms, general.html. This is the page from where I'm going to take this in here. Okay, it is coming here. No, not coming, no issue. Okay, so I will pick this form from here. Okay, so general form quick example. Here I'm going to example. This is the form. Okay, I'm going to add this one. So I will copy this middle content first, then we'll remove everything. First of all, I'm going to copy this one, and we'll add in our admin settings page here. I'm going to check. See, everything comes in this page. Okay, so, but I don't require all this. We are going to remove all this. I'm just going to keep this first form. This one is enough, and everything else I'm going to remove. Okay, so only this form has been left. Okay, so I'm going to check this one. It looks fine or not. Is home page, home is the dashboard. Okay, and this one is the settings page. Okay, fine. And this one is the general form. Okay, fine. Okay, so now it seems to be fine. Sorry for that. Oh my goodness, here I need to give again settings. Okay, so our form looks like this. We have the template from our AdminLTE, and we will make changes in this form. Okay, so I'm going to update this form, and here instead of quick sample, I'm going to add change password. Okay, we can check, see, we will do everything same like this one. Update password, username, current password, new password, confirm password. Okay, same type of thing we are going to mention. Update password. Okay, here I'm going to mention email address is fine. We are going to show email address, and here current password. This file input is not required. We can remove all unwanted code. Okay, that is not required. And this current password is required. We can copy and paste two times, one and two, and one time it is for new password that you are going to give, and one is the confirm password. Okay, and now we are going to check here, not here but here in fact. See, now it looks fine. See here, settings, update password, and here email address, current password, new password, and confirm password. We are going to change here. Email address is fine, no issue. We can give only email. Okay, no issue. And enter email. Here we can give enter current password. Enter new password. Enter confirm. And confirm password, confirm your password. Okay, like this. We can give it like this. Enter current password, enter new password, confirm new password. Okay, so now see here, enter email, this is not required. See here, we can write admin email. Okay, and here placeholder is not required because we are going to give the email that is the read only email. Okay, so I'm going to remove this one. This one is not required, and here ID also not required, type also not required, because we will just mention a read only field here. Okay, we're going to mention the read only field, just the value I'm going to fetch and will give here. Okay, so here I'm going to fetch the value, and value we can fetch from the guard. Okay, we can fetch the detail from the guard itself. Okay, but here first of all I will fetch the details here in settings function, that complete guard details I'm going to fetch here. Okay, so in the same way like we used to do in auth we used to do that auth user. Very simple enough, we can get all the details from auth user, but here we will first get the details from guard, like auth guard admin. After that we will mention user. See, for auth we will simply use it like this. If you remember, auth user, and this this does have all the details we put. Means if you want to have if you want to get the ID, then we simply use to get the ID from auth like this. But here we will not get the details like this, but we require here auth instead of auth. We require here auth guard. Okay, this is the guard, auth guard, and guard is related with admin. Okay, we are talking about the admin guard. We have created the admin guard here. We can do multiple guards, and this is the admin guard. So we will do like this, and after that user will commit like this. Okay, this is the change. Okay, this is the change, this is the difference between the simple auth and the auth guard. Okay, so here we will do like echo. We just want to check the details of auth guard admin. We can do it like this. We are going to add in print r. Okay, and this instead of this ID, I am going to fetch all the details here like this. Okay, so these are the details, attributes, and like this. Okay, so everything is coming here. You can check ID, one, name, admin type, admin mobile is there, email is there, email verified, add password, email status. Okay, all the information we are getting from this admins table, we are getting from auth guard admin. Okay, so we are getting this details as we have login from admin_admin.com. So we are getting this detail here. Okay, so here we require this one admin@admin.com because we want to fetch the complete details from this email, because then we can able to show this email there in our admin form as well. And we can also compare the password. By getting the password here, we can also compare the password. Okay, so that thing also we can do. We can get the details of admin details, complete admin details with this email. With this email, and we can show it there as well. Okay, so there is another way to show. If you don't want to get the details, then that is also fine enough. And you can directly show the detail there, admin detail there. Okay, and that is possible. Like if you want to give here like value, I can directly show here in value. I will simply show this one. There are two ways to do. One is I will simply show it like this, and here I'm going to put user, and after that email. We can try this one. That it must come though. I will remove this one. Okay, see, the admin mail has come up here. We can simply fetch, we can simply fetch from the admin guard. Okay, from guard we get this email, because we are registering this one, this complete information we are getting in guard itself. Okay, so you know, we can get anything. We can get the name as well, we can get the type as well, we can get the mobile as well. Okay, you can even show here type, like admin email. After that type also you can show here. That thing also we can get. There are two ways, like I am talking about admin type also you can show here, and here you can give type. We have all the information in guard. Here you can show admin type, sorry, not here, here this one you can remove for the time being. Okay, so you can check it out that admin type we have added admin. Okay, if there is subadmin, then it will come subadmin here. Admin type will come as subadmin. Okay, and admin name also we can show admin name, and you can even update admin name. Okay, and also you can show admin name at the top if you want to show, and here also you can give the name. And this one is not read only, you will not make it read only, you can update it, but type you can keep it read only. Here type test and placeholder . Okay, you can see the admin name as admin. Okay, and if you will remove, you will get the hint as well. If you remove, enter admin subadmin name. Okay, so you can get admin name, admin email, admin type. See, all the informations are coming from the guard itself. We are maintaining all the information in guard, so you can fetch the details like this. And this is the one way. And another way, like I am talking about, like here you can give here one variable $admin_details, and you can fetch all the details from auth guard itself. Like admin is the model where we are going to check it email, and here I am going to add that auth guard user email, this thing, auth guard user email, like this. Okay, and after that first and this admin details I'm going to send there with compact admin details. But for this one you need to add here use app admin, and now you can simply use this admin details here. Now no need to mention all this, you just require to mention here admin details itself, this one, this variable itself. Okay, and here you will just give admin details name. We can check once. Okay, now you can check that admin details. Now it is coming from the admin details variable. Simply you can give it like this, no need to give now guard. Okay, because we have all information in admin details itself, in admin details JSON string itself. So thus you need to mention it like this. Okay, so this is the another way that you can fetch the details from the admins table. Okay, and like this, and now again all the information will come up here. Okay, now you can check that all the information is coming fine. And so in next video we are going to check the current password in AJAX itself, that the password is correct or not. If the password is correct, then there is nothing we are going to do. Yeah, we can mention that password is correct also, but it is not required. But if the password is incorrect, then we are going to flash message here at the bottom or somewhere that the password is incorrect. That thing we are going to do in AJAX. Okay, so after that we are going to save its password, and also we are going to do Laravel validations once again that we have done in last video. Okay, so this more thing we are going to do for this update password form in next video. So stay tuned for that. Okay, and if you have any query, you can surely contact me in video description. Okay, that's all for now. Have a nice time. Goodbye.